Hello everyone, I am Dr. Kajal Mundada. Today we are going to discuss a short simple poem written by a Welsh poet, William Davy. The title of the poem is Money. When we talk about money or when we think about money, we find that different views are expressed for money. For example, it is said that money is the root of all evils. Or you cannot have everything in life only because you have money. Money is just a tool and you cannot have permanent bliss, happiness and contentment in your life only with the help of money. There are also the opinions that you can have everything if you are rich or if you have money. Money makes the mare go. Money makes the world go around. So in this way, various statements or views are there regarding money. In general also, it is seen or it is observed that everyone wants to be a rich man, everyone desires money. But here, the poem talks about a rich man who wants to become a poor man to find the real happiness. It is when we do not have money or when we have lost it, we understand how important money is. By the end of the poem, the poet talks that or he says that only when he became a poor man, he got true friends and that are very important for him in his life. In a way, the poet wants to say that prosperity makes friends and adversity tests them. Let's now try to understand this poem line by line. The title of the poem is Money. It is a short poem of 20 lines only. These 20 lines are divided into 5 stanzas of 4 lines each. Means in this poem we have 5 quatrains. Now all these quatrains, they express the views of a rich man. The poet is speaking in the first person. Let's now understand this poem. When I had money, money, oh, I knew no joy till I went poor. Now in the first line itself, the poet says that when I had money, I knew no joy. When I was rich, I knew no happiness. But I understood what happiness is, what joy is, only when I became a poor man. Now in the first line itself, we find that the poet has repeated the word money, money. So he is making use of the poetic device known as repetition. What is repetition? In repetition, one word is repeated in order to create rhythm. So here repetition is used in the very first line by William Davy. So he says, when I had money, money, oh, I knew no joy till I went poor. For many a false man as a friend came knocking all day at my door. He says that when I was a rich man, at that time, many false men came to my door. They kept on knocking at my door for the whole of the day. So, in a way, he wants to say that whenever you are in prosperity, many people desire to become your friends. So he has used the statement like, for many a false man as a friend. So we find that here he has made comparison between the two things. He has compared the men with the friends who feigned to be his friends. Then felt I like a child that holds a trumpet that he must not blow because a man is dead. Then he also says that he felt just like a small child. Now here the comparison is made between the poet himself and a small child. A small child, even though he has a trumpet, he cannot have the happiness of blowing the trumpet because some person is dead. Similar was the situation of the poet. Though he had many friends, though many people claimed to be his friends, though many people desired to become his friends, he was not really happy. His situation was just like a child who holds the trumpet but cannot blow it. Means the child cannot have the happiness in his life, the happiness of blowing the trumpet. In the same way, the poet also was not happy, though he had friends around him. I dared not speak to let this false world know. And that was the time, that was the situation when he was not able to tell what was there in his mind, because if he would speak, the world would know his thoughts. He was not happy, though he had many friends, though he was rich, but he had no courage to tell this openly to the world. Much have I thought of life and seen how poor men's hearts are ever light. So in the third stanza, the poet says that I have thought so much about life. I have seen so much of the world. I have seen so much of life. And I have come to know that the hearts of the poor men, they are light. They are not with some burden. They are light. How poor men's hearts are ever light. Ever, always, these people are light-hearted, and that's why they can enjoy the life. And how their wives do hum like bees about their work from morn till night. Not only that the poor men are happy, but even their wives, though they keep on working from morning to night, throughout the day, they are so happy that they keep on humming like a bee. Now, when do we hum? We hum while working when we are happy. And it indicates the happiness that is there in the life of the poor people. So, the poet here has made use of the word hum, which is an instance of onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is a poetic device or a figure of speech in which the word represents the original sound. The original sound of the bees, it also is like hum, and the word also represents the original sound. So in this way, this poetic device very beautifully the poet has employed here. So when I hear these poor ones laugh and see the rich ones coldly frown, poor men think I need not go up so much as rich men should come down. So I have observed that poor people are able to laugh, means they enjoy life. They are happy in their own lives. On the other hand, the rich men have frowns on their forehead. Now, frown on forehead, it indicates dissatisfaction. It shows displeasure, sadness, worry in life. So if you are a poor man, you can enjoy the life. But a rich man always has the tensions, worries. He has displeasure, sadness, dissatisfaction in life. And that's why the poet says that I always feel it is not that the rich that the poor men should go up. Means the poor men should become rich, but the rich men should go down. Means to find the real happiness, rich men should become poor. When I had money, money, oh, my many friends proved all untrue. So again, the same line, the first line of the first stanza has become the line, first line of the last stanza. Both first and last stanzas, they have the same line. Here again, the poet says that when I had money, many friends proved all untrue. Many of my friends, they proved to be untrue. They had not been the truthful friends. They had not been the faithful friends. But now I have no money. Oh, my friends are real, though very few. But the poet says that now I have become a poor man, but I have a few friends. And though they are few in number, they are truthful, honest friends. So in this way, we find that the poet actually celebrates having good relationships and identifying good friends when you are a poor person. In this poem, we find that the first four stanzas, they have similar rhyme scheme. From first to fourth stanza, the rhyme scheme is A, B, C, B. Except the last one. The last stanza has the rhyme scheme A, B, A, B. So this is about the rhyme scheme. We also have seen that the poet has employed different poetic devices like simile, inversion is there. Well, inversion we find in the second stanza in the very first line where the poet says, "Then felt I like a child." What is inversion? In inversion, the normal arrangement of the words in a sentence is misplaced or it is not written in the proper structure or regular structure. So in this line, we find that the poet has employed the poetic device inversion. So many poetic devices William Davy has adopted in this poem. For example, he has made use of simile, inversion, repetition is there in the first line of the first stanza and the last stanza. Then there is onomatopoeia and antithesis is also there. Now, antithesis we find in the last stanza where the poet says, my many friends proved all untrue. When we use a word like friend, friend is another name of truthfulness. But here, the poet has made use of two contrast words or opposite words like friend and untrue in the same line. And that's why this is an instance of antithesis. What is antithesis? In antithesis, striking opposition or contrast of words is used in the same line. So in this way, we find that this is a poem in which a rich man, he becomes a poor man and he is happy because he has got good friends, truthful friends when he was poor. In a way, the poem celebrates adversity, we can say. And this poem reminds me a wonderful line by a very famous Roman statesman, philosopher and dramatist Seneca. Seneca, in one of his very famous speeches, said that the good things which belong to prosperity are to be wished, but good things that belong to adversity are to be admired. Similar views we find in the essay written by the father of English essays, Sir Francis Bacon, where he says, "Prosperity doth best discover vice. Prosperity doth best discover vice, but adversity doth best discover virtue." So in this way, we find a very different approach towards life. And it is given in a very beautiful, simple way by the poet William Davy. I hope you understood this poem. Thank you.